Hi, I'm Rebecca, and I'm making this video today to talk about refusal or resistance when potty training. This is a really, really common thing, and it can be really stressful. It's something that we see posted all the time in the group, or what can you do when your child just simply says no, when they have a massive tantrum, when they seem like they're doing things wrong deliberately, or they're trying to wind you up. This, when it comes to potty training, honestly, so many people have this problem and it can be solved. It absolutely can be overcome and it can be done gently as well. It can be done in a way that's not going to involve bribery of any kind. It can be done in a way that doesn't involve sticker charts or rewards or sweets or anything like that. It can also be done in a way that doesn't involve any punishment whatsoever. So this is because this is something that so many people struggle with, I thought I would make this video today just to talk you through what some of the causes of it are and how you can deal with them. So sometimes it might seem like your child is just really smart and they know what to do and they're just not doing it. And you feel like exasperated because you've given them all the things that they need. You know, you've been through the process, you've taught them, and you know that they know better and they're just not cooperating. So this is probably like one of the most challenging things that can happen to you as a parent when you're potty training your child. And if that's you, then you will know how that feels and you will know how desperate you can feel to just sort this problem out and overcome it. But you can also feel quite helpless because you can feel like you've tried everything and nothing has worked. And what I'm going to talk to you about today is not a gimmick either. That's really important. A lot of people will offer a quick fix. And I think it's really important to understand that where resistance or refusal is concerned, there isn't going to be a quick fix. Sorry, guys, I just have to be honest with you about that, because I think if you go into it expecting that you can just solve it like really fast, that's going to be the problem. It's not going to work. And then you'll be back again at like, oh, I've tried everything and nothing has worked. So sometimes when your child seems like they know what to do, or that, you know, in fact, they may not actually feel like they're in control of the process. And that's the bit that's missing. So that's the bit where they need more internal motivation. And that comes from them wanting to do it for themselves, not because you've told them to or because you have set a goal for them. It has to become internal from them, that they kind of think, you know, I really want this to succeed. I really want this to work. I really want to be able to do this and I want to be able to do it right. So that is one of the things that's missing often when you've got a child who you know how to do it, but they're just not doing it. It's because they don't want to do it. Okay, the other thing that can happen is if your child hasn't quite got it. So that, you know, it's not that they're deliberately trying to kind of get things wrong, but they just have got a gap in their learning. And it can be really hard to identify where that gap came from and where that gap is, but it might be that as well. So one of the really important things when we're thinking about resistance and refusal is to try and separate the symptom from the cause. So the symptom can be things like them saying no, having massive tantrums, stuff that we've talked about, but the cause can actually be maybe they want more control. You know, and this is the problem with most potty training approaches, that they don't consider the parent-child relationship. They simply consider the process, you know, and there is important thing in getting the process right in terms of the actual techniques you can use to teach your child. But one thing that most potty training approaches really don't cover is how you can use the relationship that you have as their parent. And, you know, this is a thing, right? So you know your child. You don't want someone to tell you how to potty train them. You don't feel necessarily that you don't know your child enough to know what's best for them. And that's correct. You know, you absolutely know what is best for your child. You know better than anybody else. And so, you know, the problem with a lot of potty training approaches is that they kind of forget that, and they feel like you don't know anything. And they have to teach you all this stuff. And actually, that's not necessarily the truth. You know your child really, really well, and you can use that and use that relationship as a way of supporting your child and helping them to feel like they have more control. So it's about taking what you know about your child and using it to motivate them. Also, you know, on a kind of global thing, like a generalization, is that most toddlers crave mastery and independence. I have yet to meet a toddler who didn't, and I know a lot of toddlers, and they all want to be able to do things on their own, even if they can't do it, even if they don't have the competence, they want to do it, and they want to feel like they're in control. So you will know this. If you have a toddler of any age, you will absolutely have seen that in your child, I can guarantee it. So it's about tapping into that desire for mastery and that desire for independence and channeling that huge force that they have. You know, it's the only thing that they care about in many ways, you know. So if you can harness that and you can use it for them to think, yeah, you know, I really want to succeed at potty training and I want this to go right, then you have basically won the battle. Because, you know, if you get your toddler on board and you motivate them, then they will want to succeed, and therefore they will succeed no matter how long it takes. They'll engage with you. They'll listen to you. They'll want to please you. They will want to do it right. Okay, so once you have separated the symptom from the cause and recognize that actually many of the behaviors that toddlers who are refusing or resisting the potty training process are showing you is a symptom of the fact that they want more control. And that's the number one thing. Or it could be that they haven't got it, or they want things to be done on their own terms. So this again is about individualizing it to your child. So how can you solve this problem? Okay, so it's about meeting them at their level, and it's about tailoring your approach to their unique temperament as well. So there just isn't a one size fits all when it comes to potty training, because those things just don't work. So you've got to engage their cooperation and motivate them. So little bunny bear, and that's me, Rebecca, we have developed a troubleshooting course to help you exactly do these things. So the really key thing about this is that it's based on gentle attachment parenting principles, and it's all about focusing on your relationship with your child and helping you to problem solve and engaging them. You know, the techniques that we talk about is offering your child a ways to play through what they want, because we all know that children learn best when they're playing. So we use play and empathy, and all of this is evidence-based on what child psychologists and people working in the field of potty training and medical doctors and nurses and all the parents who we know have done this before. And a lot of these techniques that we use about play, for example, using dolls, using props, using these ways to teach children things, they work so well in potty training, and they will take the stress right out of things. So with these things, you can actually have fun, you know, and that's why I love the potty training thing so much. And when people come to me and they have, you know, they're seeking a consultation, and sometimes it gets that bad, you know, people get to the point where they just need someone one-to-one to consider their unique situation and ask them the right questions and then come up with a plan that's going to be right for them. So I do that, you know, I that's what I mean when I say I'm a potty training consultant, is that I do work with people one-to-one. But you know what would be even better is if you never got to that point, if you didn't need to do that, you know, if you could from the very beginning use playful techniques to help your child feel in control, and if you felt confident, you knew how to problem solve these things without getting into an argument with your child, without shouting at them, without forcing them, without doing any of these things that we know don't work, without manipulating them. You know, this is what the troubleshooting course can give you. It can give you these techniques, and it will focus on the play and empathy as a way of you being able to help your child and really engage them with this process. So most importantly, you will feel in control. You will feel empowered. All of the stuff in this course is really about giving you the tools that you need. And so if you even come across even a whiff of resistance, you've got everything you need there to help solve them. If you are deeply embedded within resistance, it's definitely going to help you. This course has got everything in it. It's got all the tools that I give to people when I do a private consultation with them. The only thing that's different between this troubleshooting course and having a one-off consultation with me is that I'm not necessarily going to hear from you about, you know, what your actual problem is and how it's manifested. But I think that for most people who are experiencing problems with resistance and refusal, that this course will help you. In fact, I know that because so many people do it and I never hear from them again, you know, which I know just means that it worked for them. And so many people do it and they say, actually, Rebecca, this was amazing and this really did help and this is what we used. And so with that feedback, we know that we're offering you something really valuable here. Hi, thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, please be sure to let me know by pressing the like button or leaving a comment, and you can ring the bell to subscribe to my channel and see future videos. You can also join my Facebook group to access more potty learning resources in the link via the description.